Hi, I'm Rick Emerson. Welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. I have no David Caruso pun with which to bring us back, so we'll just have to plunge back into this. Dan Haneckaw, who runs, among other things, the Portland history blog CafeUnknown.com. For people who haven't gone there, it is a pretty fascinating compendium of photos, text, observations, archival and historical interviews chronicling Portland and its development through the past however many decades. What prompted you to start the blog? Was there a niche in the history market that was not being served?
Well, I think the first thing, I actually was listening to talk radio, and somebody was talking on the radio, phone in, about Portland history subject, and probably something to do with Waterfront Park. And they said, you know, they could just tear down all those buildings on 1st and 2nd, because the real important stuff is on 3rd. And I was like, 1st and 2nd, that's where Portland had its start. That was the lodestone of Portland was on 1st and 2nd. 3rd, the buildings are just bigger. And so I remember thinking, you know, people might not have much of an idea of Portland history. And I took an interesting class from Chet Orloff at PSU and learned a lot more about it myself. But really, it just started off as a blog. And it was only until when I started writing about Portland history that people actually began to read it.
And you had a really fascinating article, or almost a string of articles. It was a huge analysis of Portland in 1974, and along with photos, interviews, observations from people that, you know, sort of in that moment, in the time, and it was before Nixon had resigned. And I know that is still archived there. People can go see it. It's at CafeUnknown.com. Why did you pick 1974? What was so special about that year?
I was really lucky at Powell's to basically get over the book buyer's counter an annual, like a yearbook, called Our Portland Story that was put out by the PSU yearbook staff in 1974. But instead of doing PSU, they kind of turned the camera around and said, we're going to do a Portland yearbook. Mm-hmm. And so they started looking at just how people are feeling, what they're thinking, take some pictures. They didn't cover the buildings, they covered or tried to cover the mood. And so it was really kind of a little core sample of the entire city at a moment when things really felt like the ground had shifted under them with the oil crisis and Nixon on the verge of resigning.
And there's somebody actually there, there's a poll quote that you've taken out of one of the interviews that says something about Nixon, is that he either has to quit in July or he'll be impeached in August. And I think he actually did resign in August.
Yeah, it was just like the guy called it right between the two, you know, it's going to be this or this. And it was like right in the middle. He hit it really well.
And so that's 35 years ago. What was the mood of Portland at the time, if you can sum it up in a few sentences? What were people feeling? What was the emotional tenor of the city?
I think it was very similar to kind of where we are now, and the feeling that the ground had somewhat shifted. And people were kind of looking for a new footing. And what they were doing in 1974, some of the things they were doing were interesting, are setting up the things that we take for granted and appreciate about Portland today. One of the things that they did was set up, it wasn't completed or anything, but the whole idea of a transit mall that went through the center of downtown, in which most of the buses would go through, was all being put together at that time and being built. Before that point, every bus had a different route and a different loop into downtown. It was chaos. So the transit mall was being put together. There was a whole rise in the value of how people viewed their neighborhoods and livability, and should we be actually placing a freeway over these neighborhoods. And so there was this sort of positive stream that was coming out of a fairly negative time that a lot of the benefits we're still living with today.
When we come back, we will talk about Portland of 35 years ago as chronicled in this yearbook and at your website, and we will talk about similarities between the city we live in at this very moment. We're here with Dan Haneckaw. This is Outlook Portland, back after this on Northwest 32 TV.